Hello everyone, you're watching an American Astronomical Society Worldwide Telescope tutorial on visualizing time series data in pywwt. By the end of this video, you'll have seen how to use pywwt to visualize an accelerated version of all Fermi gamma ray burst monitor detections from 2008 to 2014. We begin by going to the Quick Start section of pywwt's documentation website and following a link to a custom JupiterLab environment. Please find the Read the Docs link in the description if you'd like to follow along. Once the page loads, we create a new notebook and begin setup by making some headers and importing the packages necessary to run our example. Next, we'll retrieve the gamma ray burst data from another directory in the pywwt notebook's repository. Looking at the table, we find columns with position information, that's right ascension and declination, and we also have a column of Julian dates. We can use AstroPy's time class to read them, making sure to specify the format, and then convert them into strings that follow the ISO 8601 standard. pywwt table layers allow a few options for time column types. The ISO strings you see here, date time objects from the built-in Python module, and AstroPy time objects. That's everything we need to create a time series table layer, so let's start using pywwt. We'll create a new instance of the wwt Jupiter widget class, assign it to the wwt variable, wait for the cell to load, then right-click and select Create New View for output. Once everything is situated, feel free to click and drag or press I, J, K, and L to move around inside the viewer. Next, we upload our gamma ray burst table with the add table layer method, making sure to set the sky as our frame of reference and assign column names to the proper attributes. We can choose settings for the new layer upon its creation through keyword arguments, as we're doing here, or afterward by reassigning class attributes, like we'll do here by rescaling the points. To let pywwt know this isn't a static table, we'll set the time series attribute to true. For visualization purposes, we'll also change the time decay attribute to 1 year using AstroPy units. Time decay controls how long points take to fade away after they first materialize. By default, the viewer is synchronized with the time on your machine. Since I'm in 2019, the points disappear because it's been more than a year since the last gamma ray burst in this table took place in 2014. The next step is to manipulate time. We begin by centering the viewer at the location of the first gamma ray burst, and then setting the viewer's time to a few seconds before that event took place. After a few seconds, we see it happen and can verify that time in the viewer has indeed shifted to 2008. Noting that we don't have 6 years of real time to wait for the other gamma ray bursts, we use the playtime method to speed things up by changing the amount of time in the viewer that elapses in a real-world second. And there you have it. All that's left is to watch the gamma ray bursts and thank them for minding their distance. To try a version of this notebook yourself, navigate to the Video Tutorials folder on our Binder Hub site and open the Time Series notebook. This link to our documentation can help you do that and learn much more about pywwt. I'm Justin Otor, and we at pywwt would like to thank Mark SubbaRao for inspiring this tutorial and you for watching it. So long!